Everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The son has a place there forever. So if the son makes you free, you will be free indeed. The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. Grace and peace from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. There's a story about a man who had a huge boulder in his front yard. He grew weary of this big, unattractive stone in the center of his lawn. So he decided to take advantage of it and turn it into an object of art. He went to work on it with hammer and chisel, and he chipped away at the huge boulder until it became a beautiful stone elephant. People came from miles around to see this breathtaking work of art. A neighbor asked him, "How did you ever carve such a marvelous likeness of an elephant?" The man answered, "Oh, I just chipped away everything that didn't look like an elephant." On this Reformation Sunday, it is important for us to chip away any misconceptions we have about the significance of this day in order to reveal the pure gospel message. We are aware, of course, that on October 31st, 1517, the Roman Catholic theologian and monk Martin Luther posted on the doors of the Wittenberg Church 95 theses, arguing that there was a need to reform the Roman Catholic Church's doctrine and teachings. Luther and other reformers of his day felt that church leaders were standing in the way of revealing the true gospel message of Jesus Christ. Luther's actions set into motion a conflict between those who sought to protect the papal office and long-standing traditions of the church and those who sought to chip away the abuses of power which threatened to turn the church away from Christ's central message and focus for his disciples and for all who would follow, including us. The gift of this day is not in celebrating our Reformation roots, as though they had replaced the roots of Jewish and Catholic forebears. Far from it. Its focus is rather in celebrating our faithful and gracious God, who remains our refuge and strength, even in the flow of ever-changing human society and relationships. This is the free gift of God's grace that Paul is describing in Romans, a gift that at various points in the history of organized religion has been eclipsed by the human desire to emphasize our own achievements rather than what has been accomplished on our behalf through the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus. Rooted in the past and growing into the future, the church must always be reformed in order to live out the love of Christ in an ever-changing world. We celebrate the good news of God's grace that Jesus Christ sets us free every day to do this life-giving, transforming work. In our gospel lesson, Jesus was speaking to Jews who had come to believe in him. "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." Even though these Jewish converts had committed themselves to follow Jesus, they were proud of their heritage, and they took exception to Jesus' words. "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying you will be made free?" It's amazing, isn't it, that these well-educated Jews seem to have forgotten about their ancestors 400 years as slaves to Pharaoh of Egypt. That God had freed them through his servant Moses and had led them to the land of promise. Jesus reminded them and us that we all have sinned and fallen short of God's expectations. Therefore, everyone is a slave to sin and is in need of salvation. And the only one who has a place in God's house who can vouch for us is the Son of God, the one true God. Jesus is truth, and he shall make us free to enjoy the spiritual gifts and blessings: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These are all gifts that are especially needed right now in our world. At the time that Martin Luther was struggling with his own faith, how he could ever be good enough to inherit the kingdom of God, he encountered these words that changed his life as well as his theology in Romans chapter 3. Then what becomes of our boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. The scriptures today call us back to the source of our hope: God's steadfast covenant, his love. Just as God held Israel through every tribulation and exile, so too God holds onto us. The scriptures today call us back to baptism, the river whose streams make glad the city of God. Here are waters from which we can deeply drink and be refreshed. Here we can be washed clean and made new. The scriptures today call us back to the simple truth that is faith. God calls us with the good news because it does not depend upon our righteous achievement or our knowledge. God's call is good news because it is simply a response to a gift freely offered to us by the living Christ. Nathan Hilkers reminds us that as we go back to the sources of our life, as we are refreshed and renewed, we find true freedom. Not freedom by which we usually mean the liberty to do whatever we want to do. Rather, Jesus frees us from our sin and our compulsive search for approval, so that knowing our place in God's house, we can live in peace with ourselves, with one another, and above all with God. I will close with a prayer written by Martin Luther. Let us pray. Behold, Lord, an empty vessel that needs to be filled. My Lord, fill it. I am weak in faith. Strengthen me. I am cold in love. Warm me and make me fervent, that my love may go out to any neighbor. I do not have a strong and firm faith. At times I doubt and am unable to trust you altogether. O Lord, help me. Strengthen my faith and trust in you. In you, I have sealed the treasure of all I have. I am poor. You are rich, and you came to be merciful to the poor. I am a sinner. You are upright. With me there is an abundance of sin. In you is the fullness of righteousness. Therefore, I will remain with you, of whom I can receive, but to whom I cannot give. Amen. You can remain seated for the sermon hymn.
My bird is alive. please stand for the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. With confidence in God's grace and mercy, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Renew and inspire the church in the freedom of the gospel, O God. Where the church is in error, reform it. Where the church speaks your truth, strengthen it. Where the church is divided, unify it. Ignite in us the working of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As the earth changes, as mountains shake and the waters roar, may we care for this planet as a holy habitation for all living things. Sustain all peoples and lands recovering from natural disasters of any kind. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide areas of the world divided or traumatized by conflict, especially in our own land. Free all from the slavery and human trafficking and protect all in harm's way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Release those living in bondage to debts, chronic pain, or addiction. Grant a healing touch to those who are ill. We pray especially for the Popham and Baxter families, for Louise Eisenhower, John and Brenda Thompson. We pray also for Janine Woody and Peggy Morgan. We pray for Dick Talbert, Joanne Foster, Dan Gleason, Joanne Popham, Nancy Wilcox, Mitch Simpson, Kelly Tanner, Sandy Maxwell, Kyla Maxwell, and Brent Giles. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In this family of faith, we give thanks for courageous voices that have remained firm in their commitments to the one who frees us from sin and death.